Tonight's agenda is, we have a couple of bid openings at 6:00. 6:30, we're going to be meeting with Woody Meisner regarding the streetlight inventory. And after other business, we'll go into a non-public session. So before we start, would we please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Think we'll address the lawn care quotes first before going to the paving.
This is one that was amended.
This goes with this one. Okay, we have a amended bid proposal from Brown's Lawn and Snow. Okay, this one, I thought based on my notes, we were getting a reduction for the trimming of the shrubs at the town office. Is there somebody here from Brown's?
Yes. That includes the hedging and trimming as well.
But it seems like you went and took the liberty of reducing other costs that have no shrubs.
Right, we reduced the whole thing.
That's what we gathered.
Yeah, from the amendment that we're...
No, the amendment was only going to be because you had said that you had included the trimming of the shrubs. So you asked if you could have the opportunity to give a credit back for not trimming the shrubs. It wasn't meant to imply that you could do a revised bid.
Correct, that's the impression I under...
Yeah, that's why I started looking at this. I'm like, we don't have any shrubs down at the park and the fire station. This one is from Gordon Services. Town offices. This one is saying that they included the trimming of the shrubs at the town offices. Locations combined.
I see that dump.
So this one here was the original quote, and he sent in this confirmation that the trimming of the shrubs was included. So he's still at 10-1. And where was the...
This is Anna Proscapes.
Anna Proscapes. And did he give us one about, though, we're not at this point?
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah. what brought us to thinking that it wasn't, was his statement here. Additional service such as edging, mulching, planting, looming, reseeding, tree and brushwork, et cetera, are available based on time and material. Quotes can be provided. So, sorry, but we have.
With him, it was just, went back to him to say, you know, what would it be for the trimming?
So he's stating that it's there, okay.
So I think based on, even what we have right now, Gordon Services would be the low bid at 10-1.
Yes.
With Proscape's at?
He's at 11,750, I believe. Yeah, 11,750. Which is roughly, we'll get there, $1,700. Entertain a motion?
Motion to accept Gordon's property maintenance for the lawn care.
The dollar total?
$10,100, which includes the trimming shrubs at the town office.
I'll second it.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
Paving beds. Not too many. Need more selectmen. Take two.
Give one to Dave. He's a fourth, right?
Take two.
Fourth selectman.
You guys want to just let me know who you have in your hand? Who did I give you? Brox's one?
Mitchell, sand and gravel.
Mitchell?
Yep. I've got GMI.
And who else?
That's all I've opened.
No, but I mean, who do you have?
I've got R&D here.
R&D, okay. What's your stat, Jay?
bid, I'm seeing everything but. The specs. Here it is, all right. Thanks, thank you. You want estimated tonnage and reclamation and all that, David, or you want a bottom dollar?
Unit cost. Who's are you reading?
This is from,
GMI.
GMI.
Estimated tonnage.
Well, skip the tonnage, just the unit cost.
Unit cost, estimated reclaiming.
Yeah.
$27,339.
Do they give a unit cost?
Per ton in place, or?
Nope, for reclaiming.
Reclaiming per square yard.
Yeah.
$1.05, includes fine grading. Timber top, final grade timber top road is 40 cents per square yard. They're estimating the square yardage at 14,189.
Final grade. Okay.
What are you looking for now, you want?
Mix, paving.
Price per ton in place.
Yeah.
$64.30 per ton. Price per ton without wrap in place.
So $64.30 per ton?
Right, virgin material, I believe.
Virgin, okay. Yeah, it was wrap?
That's with wrap, that's with the wrap.
Oh, that's wrap?
Yeah.
Okay.
Price per ton without wrap in place, $68.30 a ton.
Next one.
You want a total cost?
No, I think it's all based on the tonnage.
So we have Mitchell Sand and Gravel.
Reclaim.
The price on reclaim?
Yes.
$1.70 a yard, square yard.
Yeah.
Ton in place, $62.89.
They qualify if that's wrap or?
That'd be with wrap, I'm guessing, because there's the next line is without wrap.
Okay.
$64.89 without wrap in place. And their final number includes timber top fine grading. It's not an, there's not an additional amount.
So fine grading's included.
Yes.
Now you said something about timber top. We're also doing. Are we doing Greenbrier?
Yeah.
Top and Greenbrier.
Yeah, but I think.
Okay.
But he just, like his. I didn't see the bid that went out, but there must be something in there about fine grading on timber top, because it was mentioned in GMI and in Mitchell. GMI's was an additional, Mitchell's is included.
There should be fine grading on
the
Greenbrier also. No, even on that.
On timber top?
Yep.
There's a section of the road that's only fine grade. There's no reclaim to this gravel right now.
Right, that's.
So that's why. This one section is going to be reclaimed and graded, and the other section is just going to be graded. That's what the.
There was no line for fine grading, which is
right.
We brought it up. Pete said just add a line item.
Explain that one more time, because I'm still lost. Timber top is going to get.
Timber top, the paved section.
Oh, okay, I see what you're
saying. Reclaimed and graded.
Yeah.
And then the gravel section is, there's no reclaim most of it, so it's just.
Right, okay.
So that's what the confusion is.
All right, but everybody's got the fine grading for the reclaim?
I separate fine reclaim and fine grade with two different square yardages, so.
Okay.
Right, this one here as well, the other one I'm looking at.
Okay.
I included mine for Mitchell, everything in the reclaim.
Okay. Mitchell. So your okay. Okay.
R and D.
Yep.
Estimated reclaiming. What are you looking, for?
Price for reclaim.
Price for reclaim. 68 cents a square yard.
Ooh.
And
then the fine grade per square yard is 39 cents.
How much was the fine grade, Jay?
Fine grade per square yard?
Yes.
39 cents.
39. Mix?
Price per ton in place?
Yep.
62.04. Price per ton without wrap in place, 66.04.
Okay. Go ahead.
One second. This is for Brock's. So we have reclaimed per square yard, $1.28.
Okay.
Price per ton in place. 60.99.
Give me that number again.
60.
60.
60.99.
Okay.
Without wrap in place. 63.99. And then they have fine grading per square yard. So the reclaim per square yard is 128, but the fine grade, 62 cents a square yard. So they have two numbers here with wrap and without wrap for total cost.
Yep, 62.
So the reclaim and fine grade is $1.28 on the first item, and the second item.
Who was just you? The fine grading though is strictly for timber top.
The reclaim item.
Yes.
Specified fine grade inclusive in the reclaim.
Okay.
Item.
Okay.
So reclaim and fine grade for the specified reclaim is one item.
Okay.
Timber top only is 14,189 square yards at 62 cents.
Mitchell? you. Your price
includes
fine grading and reclaiming in that one number. How did you carry the fine grading for Timber Top?
Sorry.
What's that?
Okay.
That's in the lumps.
Two sides. 14,189 was the end quantity. So it's at 52 cents.
So on your proposal, we need to add.
Mm-hmm.
How much was that?
52 cents.
52 cents.
But that's the overall price. We've already got that in there.
All right, but when we're looking at the unit cost, because nobody knows how many tons there are going to be, 52 cents.
So how do you go about adding that at this point? That's a new number.
That's a good question. Well, it's not a new number. It's in his total number, he's got that in there. But it's not broken out, and that's why when they read the proposal and what I typed match, and I'm saying, well, where did the fine grading for Timber Top come in?
Right.
It's included in the $1.70.
But Timber Top doesn't have...
Right.
Reclaim.
Well, I stuck it in there with that because there's no line item for that. So $1.70 is included. There's like $7,380 that's stuck in there. That's included that $1.70.
So in order, because you're saying your $1.70 a square yard for the reclaim includes fine grading, but it also includes the fine grading of Timber Top that has no reclaim. So, do you have what just your reclaim and final grading at the reclaimed areas are per square yard?
It's about $1.52.
And you were at 52 cents a square yard for fine grading.
Yeah.
Okay, did we finish with rocks? Rocks were all set on.
Yeah.
Okay. I have PJ Keating's. We have reclaiming is $2.20. Price per ton is $73. And $78 without.
Is that 78?
78, yep.
Thank you.
advanced excavating and paving. Okay, reclaim. Reclaim with fine grading is $1.45. Fine grade only is 60 cents. Price per ton with wrap is $69.80. And no bid for price per ton without wrap. Okay, 145. Rocks 128. Anybody here from GMI? Who has, Jay, you have GMI's proposal?
Do.
Where did they qualify with their reclaim unit cost? Did that include fine grading or is?
They had a line for fine grading.
Okay.
It was 40 cents per
40
square
cents,
yard.
Yeah. So their combined reclaim and fine grading will be $1.45. And R&D.
Excuse me.
You guys have an opinion? Because based on the way I'm reading this is I've got Brock's as the low bid at $1.28 for the reclaim. He's $1.28 for the reclaim and fine grade, and R&D would have been 107, so he would have been lower, but the cost per ton again, if we go with the wrap, there's a difference of $1.04 or $1.05, and on the virgin there's a difference of $2.05.
Do it without wrap, I'd prefer to.
What's that?
I'd prefer to do it without wrap. You get a better road, I believe.
we haven't proven that yet, that's why I'm wondering.
Well, are there any roads that have been done without rap?
With?
Any of the roads we've paved in the last 5 years been done with virgin top, base coat and top?
What we did last year with,
Greenville?
Was it Mitchell that, no, Mitchell?
Mitchell last year.
Yeah, you guys just quoted virgin last year.
Yeah.
And then I think when Brock's came in to finish what you guys couldn't do, that was rap?
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Technically, rap is a better match.
Yeah.
Really?
Yes.
I learned something.
Do you have the totals that he came up with?
I was just looking at square foot cost, but give me a minute.
Okay, yeah, sorry about that.
John, you didn't run these numbers already?
Nope.
Let's see. 8632.
I have to ask the question, I'm intrigued. You say that with rap is a better product, yet it's cheaper.
That's correct, it's obviously recycled.
So recycled.
Excuse me?
It's obviously recycled, it's millings that are coming off of wherever.
Mm-hmm.
And it's basically reintroduced right into the plant. You have an asphalt content, for us, it's an asphalt content savings, which is huge. Again, mostly, you know, Hampshire DOT mix designs include rap, not virgin mixes.
Mm-hmm.
So, and I think if you check with the quality control directors for heating rocks, continental plant.
Can we get it right on this?
I think it all kind of fall towards relying on a rap design, mix design.
Thank you, I just thought it was odd that.
If you'd like a detailed explanation,
no.
I can, seriously, I can.
That's okay, no, I appreciate it, I just.
FTC directors, pretty up, you know, high in the list of knowledge.
Okay.
I
I wonder why. That's the question.
Good.
It's 2,000.
It's all, yeah, it's like 2,000 less.
Right. Yeah.
Could I ask?
You mentioned that day.
So, you're looking at overall.
Hang on a second.
Okay.
62, go ahead.
It's consistently about 2,000 tons less. Almost across the board. There's yours. There's that one, there's that one, there's one there, 88, that one's 90.
That's why we do it by the ton.
Right, but.
Yeah. The question is, if it's that much less, then apparently we're getting that much less. No, right.
That's why all I'm doing is saying, no matter what unit I take, if I just arbitrarily pick the number, but for my calculation I'm doing now, I'm just taking the quantities off of Peter's square yardage, and I used the tonnage off of, whose proposal is this? This is Advanced Excavating's. I just, it's an arbitrary.
Yeah, but they've all been given the same square yard.
Right.
As in the proposal, so why is that tonnage?
Because we need to give them the tonnage so that.
So they're all deciding how much to put down?
No, because when you put down a ton of mix at 2 inches thick, it's a ton of mix. And that's what we're paying by, is by the ton.
Mm-hmm.
So, if we put down 100 tons, or we put down 1,000 tons, it's the unit cost that's gonna prevail.
Sure.
Mm-hmm.
But the question is 2,000 ton different on this one bid to like five others?
Right, so even if one said 1,000 tons and the other one said 10,000 tons, that's why when you guys started reading the numbers, all I wanna know is that unit cost.
Right, but I guess my question is, you know, why the huge difference in the expectation of tonnage?
Oh.
Yeah, that was the question.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's the conversation.
683, what's the others at?
I've got 8808, I've got 9.
8860.
This one's got 9,000.
Yeah, so it's.
Yeah.
So probably what happened was we didn't top one of the roads. That could be what it is. I think it's mine that you're talking about.
Yeah.
I think what it is, I didn't add top in one of the roads. That's what I thought it was.
Okay.
Because I know last year they had one road, had both, they have 2-inch base and they have 2-inch tile. I went over a Greenville Road and just based it. And I was, I think he's doing the same thing this year. Unless he plans on doing, I thought he was just doing base on that second part of on Timbertop.
Correct, we're gonna top Greenville.
We're gonna top Greenville.
And we're gonna base and top Greenbrier.
Yeah, oh, you're gonna base and top Greenbrier, that's where, I could've missed that one.
And then we're gonna reclaim and base Timbertop. Right? I believe that's the plan of attack.
I think it's binder and top on the paved section right now, and then just binder only on the.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, it's completely.
Well, see, when Peter and I discussed that a little bit, maybe he had mentioned, because I don't think we had discussed Greenbrier top. I think we were just binding Greenbrier as well.
I can't remember my notes for that.
Yeah, I know, I don't have my notes with me either. But he was.
I do.
Good. He was wondering if we shouldn't bind and top Greenbrier, because then we're done on that side of town.
I think it comes out a lot nicer when you do both. Because you see last year where Greenville split a little bit.
Yeah, it split a lot.
Getting back in there. And the other two sections, you did both, you topped and you binded and topped. And they actually held together a lot nicer. And It was a tough winter, that's for sure.
Woody's hanging in there with us.
Thank you, Woody.
I'm thinking about going home and having supper.
We can call you.
I don't know, it's dark, I don't get out.
Well, you know how to go home now, because you know where all the lights are, so we're all set.
I'm sure Holly has something important to contribute here. You don't wanna keep him either.
I don't think Holly's on the agenda.
Right, Holly's here for entertainment, I think.
Did you know that, Holly?
I'll put it in the letter, I can answer it at any time. Or just before Memorial Day.
And our Memorial Day's in 3 weeks, right?
Yeah. Yeah, the 20th.
Certainly, I can come back next week, but there's no rush on mine, right?
That's fine.
It's up to you, Woody, yeah, that's, however you wanna do it.
Yeah, all right, I can do that.
We're not that much longer, you waited this, but it's up to you.
Well, I don't know, I've heard that before.
Bye, Woody.
The doctor's office, right?
He's getting closer, he's only got a couple more numbers.
Well, I don't think we need to run all of these, what I'm saying is, if I just take the, actually, would R&D come in? R&D at 68, for the reclaim, and 40. Wait, that's 107.
That's what you're saying, right?
Yep.
Right now, using 8,885 tons of mix, 8,632 square yards of reclaim and fine grade.
How many square yards? I'm sorry.
8,632.
It's gotta be more than that.
I'm not done yet.
I'm sorry.
I'm not done yet. That's the reclaim and fine grade. And then the fine grade at 14,189.
Well, you've got 18,707 square yards of reclaim and fine grade just on Timbertop.
I'm reading the bid proposal is what I had used, which had 8,632 square yards. 2-inch base coat in Timbertop Road, which is 18,000. Greenbrier was 8,632. Timbertop was 18,707. 18,707. Where did I get the 14,189? Did one of these?
14,189 is the.
All right. In I think in any case, if you just hear me out, I'm just using those units, okay? So whether those units were 100 or 100,000, comparing Brock's, Mitchell, and R&D using the same units, but taking each individual's unit costs and coming out to see where they would stand. On the mix, at 8,885 tons, we've got Brock's at 541,896, Mitchell at 558,777,65, and R&D at 551,225,40. So right between the R&D and Brock's, there's roughly a little less than $10,000 there. Looking at the reclaim and fine grade, and I used 8,632 square yards. Brock's would have been 11,048. Mitchell would have been 13,120, and R&D would have been 9,236.
Mike, just a quick point. The more square yardage that you do for the reclaim,
yeah,
that number, because our number was lower on the reclaim end, so there's actually 27,339 square yards of reclaim in fine grade. You've got 18,707 on timber top, right on the front sheet, and 8,632 on greenbrier.
Okay. So say there's 30,000. Brock's would have been 38,400.
Woody, we'll see you next week.
Yeah. Mitchell would have been 45,600, and R&D would be 32,100. The difference between Brock's and R&D is roughly 6,300, but you're still 10,000.
Right, they're doing all the numbers there. They are actually still low, but it's only by like $300 at the end of the day.
I don't see that.
I think you're right.
All right, you know what we're gonna do?
There's another 20 something cents
right
difference just in the fine grade of timber top times 14,000 and something.
Why don't we do this? I'll put this onto a spreadsheet, meet with Peter, and we will publish these out.
Okay?
Yeah. But I
all
think
right,
from what I'm seeing here, unless something pops out, it looks like Brock's had the right numbers, which I think you agreed with, but it's the quantity or the delta that you think is closer.
Right. Okay.
What are the numbers?
That shot I can get?
No,
my point is the larger the quantity is
for the reclaim,
square yardage and reclaim,
yeah,
in the fine grade number by itself on timber top, because that's a whole separate number.
Right.
He's
yep
saying that's going to balance.
The larger those numbers are,
yep,
we're going to be closer and closer and closer.
But I don't think that your numbers based on the cost per ton of the mix is going to be enough to offset.
Because something per ton difference.
It's $2 and R&D was 62.04 and Brock's was 60.99.
It's
$1.05. Yeah, $1.05.
Right. So $1.05 times 88.86 is
just about $9,000. Yeah.
Right. But what I'm saying is, we're $1.07 for the reclaim and grade, their dollar, so it's 21 cents times 27,000.
You are, yeah, $1.07 for reclaim and fine grade.
Right.
And...
And he's $1.28.
Right.
So it's 21 cents.
Yeah.
Times 27,339 for that section.
It's gonna be roughly less than 6,000.
Yep, just under 6,000. And then there's a whole other section that we are 23 cents cheaper than. That's 14,000 something square yards.
Which is gonna be 2,800?
Just under 3,300. So that's what I'm saying. It's very, very, very close.
Well, we'll see where they land up.
Okay. All right.
Okay.
Yeah, I just wanted to let you know. Thank you.
Yep.
Thank you very much.
Thanks. I understand what you're saying.
What threw it off was Peter gave everything out in square yardage, and everybody quoted per ton.
I still don't know what we're going to spend to pay.
If you did the math, you could have figured it out.
The numbers that flew around here, and you want...
No, I understand what he's saying. It's like, yeah, if you look at those pieces and how they go out, it could be a lot closer than
you
think.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I completely understand what you're saying, because
I do it well. But
yeah. Oh, where do we sit?
Yeah.
I don't know.
Right, but yeah, I'd like to know how. So did we not accept a bid tonight? We got. I don't remember.
We have an
motion. Did we award it?
No.
No, we did not award it. What I had said was we will put this onto a spreadsheet with the quantities that Peter has.
Okay.
Then put their unit costs and find out where it's
at. So we're going to revisit it.
We're going to what?
We're going to revisit this?
Yeah. You want to do it? You want to take the bids and
do it? No,
I wasn't sure where we were
with this whole thing. Cause
that way, then you'll be in the loop.
It just went around and around. That's all.
You don't have to use that. You don't have to use a spreadsheet. You can just do it on paper. It's okay.
Yeah. An applicant, say.
Okay. I was expecting to award. Yeah. That's right. What do you want home? You have to eat.
Well, that was the criteria. See you guys later. Is this a bid?
Yes, that's a bid.
That's a bid.
Okay. 3, 4, 5. I have all the numbers written down, so I shouldn't need that. I am going to take. Yes. One announcement we wanted to make was it was brought to our attention that based on the vote that occurred in March to no longer have a budget committee for the town of New Ipswich, that even though the vote was not to have a budget committee, the budget committee needs to remain in place until March of 2019 when we have the next election, so it's good for 1 year. So the people that had run for the position have been notified of that. And have any of them come in to take the oath of office? Okay, but they've been notified. So we will go through that process again this year. That being said, we need a selectman's rep for the budget committee. Any volunteers?
You had so much fun last time.
Yeah, I'll sit in on it.
You're going to attend, Jay?
Excuse me?
Did you say you were going to attend?
Yeah. I would like folks to know too as well, David, that although the budget committee has been abolished starting in March of 2019, that the Board of Selectmen would like to put a finance advisory committee in place for the budget season 2019.
Mm-hmm. And
just so people are aware.
Yeah, and that was the intent, but we'll have to put forth a warrant article.
Right. That's
yeah.
Would it go into effect right away, or would you have to wait a year?
Well, good question.
That one goes into effect.
Amazing how that works.
I know. No bids on the painting.
Yeah, that's unfortunate.
Yeah.
Marks.
Ollie.
Yeah.
Before we go into non-public, is there something you want to do?
I just want to deliver this letter asking for a selectman to do the welcome at the Memorial Day observance, morning and afternoon, with three stops. South Cemetery, Center Cemetery, and Storage Monument.
Okay.
You're a patient man, Ollie. You hung around here for half an hour to bring that to our attention. Thank you. You could have just slid it across the table like you were thinking. I mean,
well, I didn't want to be rude. I was tied up with the new trustees longer than I thought.
So did Mr. Crook accept the trustee position?
Mr. Crook?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
I walk with him often.
Yeah.
Or I nailed him over there. He took the oath of office and paid a $50 fee.
Great. Yeah. Yeah. He knows that's monthly, right? Thanks,
thank
Ollie.
You, gentlemen.
Good night.
Thank you.
Just to make that announcement, is that on Sunday, May 20th, the town of Newark, which will hold its observance of Memorial Day. As in the past years, there'll be a morning and an afternoon parade and observance program. The morning parade will form in Smithville Center on Gowan Road at 9:30 a.m., stepping off at 10. The route will proceed to the South Cemetery, and then it will be coming back to Smithville. The afternoon parade will form at the Congregational Church and will step off at 1 o'clock p.m. and proceed to Center Cemetery. After that observance, it will continue down Main Street to the Soldiers Monument and will then proceed from there to Memorial Field, and refreshments will be provided to parade participants. You guys can each pick which one you want to do. Typically, we'll each do a welcome at one of the three stops. You come back for more?
I did. I just have one last comment for you.
Sure.
Not a bad thing. I got to do my a little bit of a salesman pitch for you, and I apologize, but I just after looking at everything, with the reclaim and fine grade section, and then just the standard just fine grade section.
Yep.
And based on the 80, 85 for tons. Based on all of Peter's numbers as far as what he put out, it's very, very, very close between us and Box. It's like $325. And I just wanted to, as far as we're concerned, as our New Haven, obviously we think we do a very good job. We've done a few guys in the past, just comparing it to what you did get for David for last year. I just want to make sure that you guys knew all the attention and detail that we do. When we do a top and row, we do grind every driveway. That wasn't done last year. Greenbrier Road, if you look at that right now, I mean, the whole middle half of that road's all opening up.
And what's the cause of that?
What's that?
What's the cause of that?
Could be a number of things, to be honest. It could be mix,
yeah.
Compaction.
Mm-hmm.
One thing that's not in your spec that we did every single year that we're here, and we take pride in it, is we do, when we have our full paving package come in with our rolling package, I don't know if you guys have seen it, but our middle roller is a pneumatic rubber tire roller. It's a $250,000 roller with an operator on it. It's not in the spec. We make sure it's there. Helps with compaction tremendously. We've done that on all of your roads that are here. I drove all our roads that we did 2 years ago before this meeting, and they all look beautiful.
Well, I got a question for you.
Sure.
Because I know that same situation occurred on, I believe, the road you paved was Perry Road. and we had to split down the middle, you guys at least came back and
yeah.
crack sealed it.
Okay.
But it was one that split down the middle and...
There was an issue, and I'm not passing the
ball. That's fine.
There
That's
was
fine.
An issue 3 to 4 years ago with the New Hampshire DOT spec in regards to wrap.
Mm-hmm.
They did make an adjustment to the amount of wrap that's in the mix. And that issue has been resolved, it seems as though anyway. And I'm not passing the buck, mm-hmm. we're not perfect.
Yeah.
But
yep.
at the end of the day, we do try to make it right, if there are any issues. Actually, when I did ride the roads, I did ask Peter, I said, are they doing anything about this? And he said he didn't know at that point if they were. But my point is here, I don't want to come and bother you guys. I
yep.
just wanted to give a little bit of a sales pitch. I think if you run the numbers, understanding what's going on here with his number of 128 is for a reclaim and fine grade on the reclaim and fine grade roads.
Right.
And then the 62 cents is just for that.
Timber top.
Right. When you run the numbers, I've done only three times. It's literally $300 difference. They are low, I understand.
Yep.
But it's so close that it's almost, I'm just hoping that you guys think of the fact that past performance and stuff like that. I think we did a very good job. Hopefully you guys agree.
Well, did you see anything wrong with the road that they did for us last year?
I'm not going to cut everyone's work up.
Oh.
I'm just, no, I honestly,
yeah,
Brock's, we actually do a lot of work for Brock's. I'm not
yeah.
going to cut up Brock's. I'm just
yeah.
mentioning that we obviously appreciate your business that we've had in the past and we love doing it. And
yes. Yeah.
It is what it is. But I just wanted to make sure I put my little piece in.
Good. Thank you.
All right.
Good so job.
Thank
Have
you
a good evening.
Thank you. Any other business before?
It was more the sorry, it's more
it
the
went twice, maybe. Three times.
No, it's more of like, I guess what I'm saying, it's more of like what you get. As far as the grinding of the driveways, never been in the spec. Every single, do you understand what I'm saying with that?
Yes, yeah.
Okay, so when we do the binder, we bring the binder equal to all the driveways.
Yeah.
And then we come back with a skid steer and a grinder, and that's typically usually has a cost to it. But we always throw it in, whether it's 60 driveways, 80 driveways.
What about raising the structures? Do you guys do that?
We can do it, absolutely.
But it's not in those numbers?
No. It
right.
wasn't in
okay.
the spec.
Okay.
Is there any structures on these roads?
Yeah.
Which ones?
Greenville has maybe three or four.
They're off the road, though, aren't they?
No. Matter of fact, one is in the pavement that we're... that was actually topped already, and it's probably 8 inches lower than the pavement.
Oh, really?
Was, yeah.
Yeah, that's something that would have to be cut open and readjusted.
Yeah.
But I,
yeah.
like I said, I'm not sitting here begging.
Oh, no.
I'm not going to get on my knees or anything, but I just wanted to let you guys know, just so it's known, the attention to detail that we
yep.
do take a lot of pride in. Smaller kind of family-owned company. You know, the owner comes up periodically, you know, through the whole thing to make sure that everything's done right because he's very proud of the name on the door. So
good.
I just want to make sure you guys know.
Right. Yep.
Thanks.
Thank you.
Appreciate it.
Hang on, John. Just to make you guys aware that highway department's on 410s.
Don't they normally come in with that request?
He talked to me. Oh, he asked me about it. And said that he would like to start at the beginning of May and asked if I would bring it to the attention of the selectmen. So that's what I'm...
So just, they shouldn't
I
be
said,
on it, yeah.
Well, he wanted to start at the beginning of the month.
Yeah.
Which is...
So my question, just so I know, so some of them are on four, and then, or everyone's four, and everyone's got the same day off.
Correct.
Or is it
it's Monday through Thursday. Unless the decision is made to do something different. He just wanted it brought to the attention of the Board of Selectmen, so that's what I'm doing.
Well, I know we've had this discussion in the past, and I don't know or haven't seen the benefits of the 410s versus the 5/8s.
I don't know as if you'll see a benefit. I don't think it makes it any. I don't think you get any more or any less production out of 410s than you would 5/8s. The reason I've never been opposed to it, because I've looked at it from both sides, is I just think of these guys that are out all winter. And it's kind of nice to have a long weekend during the summer when you know you're going to be you're on call 24/7 for 5 months, so that's why I'm in favor of it.
Yeah, I wouldn't, but typically I didn't think we started this early.
Well, that could be, I don't know.
Typically, I thought they had gone after Memorial Day and up to Labor Day.
I don't remember. I work.
Yeah, that's typically the summer season. But
I can,
you know, stretching them for, I don't know, I'll be quiet, listen to them.
Well, like I said, my only thing is, you know, it's coverage, you know. If there is some sort of issue, we've got everyone on a 3-day weekend instead of going. Some of them have Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and some of them have Saturday, Sunday, Monday. I don't have a problem giving 3 days off, but I'd rather see a staggered where we have some sort of coverage, especially when you've got, you know, schools are still in session through second week of June, things like that. So that's my take on it, you know.
Yeah, I'd agree if we had a large enough staff that we could get work done, but if you split five people into
two
different...
It's like usually half of you come with me.
Yeah.
Well,
and I mean, I've had this discussion other times, so then Saturday and Sunday we should have somebody available as well.
Right? Why, school's not open?
No, but it's... And I think that was part of his argument.
Yeah.
I don't think it was the whole argument. Just... I told Pete I'd bring it up, so I brought it up.
I'd like to suggest going from Memorial Day to Labor Day.
So 4 months instead of six, because he wanted to go...
It should be even less than that. It should be June, July, and August.
Is that the decision? Is that...
We've never had him on for 6 months.
I can tell you that.
No,
I know, but I wasn't sure. I can't remember what we worked when I was down there. I don't know how many. Honestly, I don't know when we started. I thought it was May 1st and we were done Labor Day, but I could be wrong. Something to look at, I guess. We could.
Well, I hope he hasn't started working tents.
I believe he has.
Well, we should either make a decision or hold off on it. What's your thought?
You want to go from June to Labor Day, is that what you're thinking?
Mm-hmm.
Well, I wouldn't even have a problem going from New Ipswich Labor Day observance to
Memorial Day?
Yeah, Memorial Day. New Ipswich Memorial Day observance through Labor Day. Reason being is, I mean, this is, we're coming into, I mean, we've sat here and we've talked about what's going to make, like trying to improve and make our town look nice and what draws people in, and we've got this observance coming up, and, you know,
So, help me out, I missed
that. So what I'm saying is, you know, instead of, because I'll be honest, depending on what they're doing, a 10-hour day, you're at a certain point, you're done for the day, no matter whether you're still having to do work outside to prepare stuff after so many hours, you're tired, plain and simple.
Right.
Okay.
Yeah.
So if we are coming up to a point when we're going to have communities coming in for our Memorial Day observance, I would much rather know that we have spent the time efficiently to make our town look nice leading up to Memorial Day, instead of them bailing out on Thursday, and then we have Friday, Saturday, parades on Sunday, and we've got an issue. That's just my take.
Yeah, I'm thinking everything that they're working on now, I don't know if you saw that.
Yep, I saw it.
He's getting prepped for, you know, replacing culverts and
sure.
that type
mm-hmm.
of thing. So mm-hmm. I just thought if you're doing it for the summer, typically not the, astronomical summer, but the summer season for most people, it's Memorial Day to Labor Day, and that's given them 3 months of long weekends, which I think is awfully generous of the town in the first place, but not that it's makes any monetary difference, but it is a morale thing for the guys, which is deserved.
No, it is deserved.
It is, and that's, I mean, John goes back to the 10 hours you usually had enough. You can't tell a guy that when he's 22 hours into plowing, you know what I mean?
No, I understand that, but at the same point, I mean, that's why we've talked about these guys, you know. I mean, we brought it up on when George worked all day at the transfer station, then went out and plowed.
Gary.
I mean, that's but I understand that. So, but all I'm saying is, you know, I agree. I think let's reward them. But I think 5 months is.
5 months?
Well, 4 and a week or whatever is a little much.
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, I agree more with either whether it be New Ipswich Memorial Day or Memorial Day. So Memorial Day observed, Memorial Day through Labor Day.
I'd make a motion then to go from Memorial Day to Labor Day. Is there a second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Those opposed?
I'll just
abstain. Those with no opinion?
You have an opinion, it's okay.
So Warwick Mills wants to continue leasing,
mm-hmm.
but they asked if it could be for 3 years rather than 2.
Isn't I think it should be 1 year rather
isn't
than
isn't there something three? About we can't commit for more than a certain period of time?
Yes.
I don't know that, but I can
check on that.
Can you ask for it under 2 different ones if you feel they're both under?
Sure.
Okay.
I was trying to look at the calendar to figure out how Pete can adjust this week so that they.
Well, Pete should be reminded that shouldn't have happened.
Well,
he knows that.
I'll go down and see him tomorrow. I'll call him tonight. Well, he asked me about it, and I said, yeah, go ahead, start, and I'll run it by the other two. So.
Well, they only have so far one.
They started Monday, so Monday, Tuesday. Tomorrow they'll be in for 6 because they don't know any different. So he'll have to adjust the rest of the week somehow. I'll call him.
Okay. Make a motion to go into non-public session under RSA 91A3, sections B and C, the hiring of any person as a public employee or matters which if discussed in public would likely affect adversely the reputation of any person other than a member of the public.